Welcome to today's video on designing a twisted pencil stand. Let's go to Tinkercad.com. Now, we'll log in using our school Gmail account and you can join your teacher's classroom using her class code. Once you've logged in, your screen should look like this. Click the Create button and select 3D Design to begin designing your project. Before we start designing, check the settings in the lower right-hand corner. Make sure the units is inches, and the length and width should be set to 8 inches by 8 inches. Make sure that these settings are the default, and then close your settings. To start designing our pencil stand, I'm going to go to the right-hand side and click the search button in the menu. Then I'm going to search for the twisted polygon, like so. Now I'm going to drag the second option onto my work plane, and I'll use the corner gray button to set the width to 2.5 inches, and the length also to 2.5 inches. Next, I'm going to use the center gray square. I'm going to click on it and set the height to 4 inches, like so. If you like, you can also adjust the amount of twist on the bottom and on the top to customize the design of your twisted pencil stand. I think I'm happy with how this looks, so I'm going to go ahead and click off my shape, X out of the search menu, and now I'm going to drag a hollow cylinder onto my work plane. This time, I'm going to set the dimension to a width of 2 inches by a length of 2 inches as well, and the height will set to 3.75 inches. I'm going to leave it as a hollow cylinder so I can make a hollow pencil stand, and I'm going to use my cursor to drag over both components on my work plane. Then I'm going to go to the top right hand corner and use the align tool so that the hollow circle can merge with the solid twisted pencil stand. Then I'm going to select both items and click the group button, like so. This might take a moment, and then you should have your pencil stand complete. You can look through it to make sure your hole did not cut through the base of your pencil stand. And if you'd like to customize the polygon, you can double click on your figure and again adjust the bottom twist and the top twist. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed.